The question is, can meditation be passionate? Indeed, this is the only way meditation to exist and the only way meditation can help. Passion implies energy. Passion implies fire. Passion is life. If you are doing meditation just so, without any energy, without any passion, without any intensity, without fire, nothing is going to happen. Nothing is going to happen if you are doing the meditation just so, without intensity, without energy, without fire. Then your meditation will certainly lack the energy. First you have to create the energy, and when energy begins to overflow inwards, the process of transformation begins. And unless the process of transformation begins, there is no use of meditation. Or we can say meditation is not happening. Unless the process of transformation begins, unless the energy begins to flow inwards, your energy continues to move outward in superfluous things. This one said something bad about you, that one is making jokes at you, laughing at you, and things like these. Our entire life is lost in those things. So when I say inward means, you have known, experienced that you are not the body, you are not the mind, you are the being, the inner self, the essence. There is a synergistic harmony, you are part of the whole. Then how can you be upset with something that is said by someone else? Just as your right hand does not feel offended when left hand does something, because the right hand and the left hand is part of one synergistic harmony. Unless this thing comes, there is no way that your energy is moving inwards. And when this begins to happen, you are more inward, more introspective, meditation is beginning to happen, and then it will certainly transform you. For this, tremendous energy is required to go within, to go beyond dualities. Tremendous energy is required to get upset with what the other has said. Nothing is required, but to not upset, but to be happy under all circumstances, tremendous understanding is required. And understanding is nothing else if there is no energy. If you are praying just as a formality and love has arisen in your heart, then your prayer is meaningless. It is absent. If you are praying to God without passion, there will be no connection between you and God. Only passion can become the bridge. Passion here does not refer to desires. It refers to energy that is required. Only passion can become the bridge. The thirst, the hunger. The more thirsty you are, the more is the possibility of the inner connection. The more thirsty you are, the more is the possibility of inner connection. If you are utterly thirsty, or you become just a thirst, when you are utterly thirsty, then you are not thirsty. Instead, you have become the thirst itself. You have become the thirst itself, and your whole being is consumed by your passion or energy, and then only something happens. In that moment, when you Your total intensity is there in that moment when there is 100-degree passion, or the passion has reached the 100-degree mark, something indeed happens. Unless the water begins to boil, reaches the 100-degree mark, nothing can happen. The vapors will not be there. You cannot use the water for any purpose, whether you are making tea or coffee or anything else. For that, the water, the energy has to be so intense that it has reached the 100-degree mark. This is passion. When something reaches its ultimate mark, then passion is at its peak. Therefore, just as you cannot use a lukewarm water for making tea or coffee or anything else, never be lukewarm. If your meditation is lukewarm, it is not going to help you. And unless meditation transforms your head, it is of no use. People live a lukewarm life. They are neither this nor that. Hence, they remain mediocre. If you want to get beyond mediocrity, means the state of being mediocre, create a life of great passion or intensity or energy overflow. You are so much lost in your thing, whatever you are doing, the more intense your energy becomes, the more passionate you become, nothing is going to happen. So whatsoever you do it passionately. If you sing, then sing passionately with total energy and crossed into it. If you love, then love passionately with totality. If you paint, then paint passionately. If you talk, then talk passionately. If you listen, listen passionately. I have given a few examples. This is to signify that whatever you are doing, do it passionately with your total energy, total intensity, with total awareness into it. Only then something will happen. And from where will you start having? And then from everywhere you will start having contact with God. The inward journey begins where passion has reached its pinnacle. If you are painting with utter passion, your painting will become your meditation. Remember, I say, whatever work you do passionately with your total energy into it, that becomes meditation. And the creativity is born out of that. The more intense you are, the more full of energy you are creative then. There is no need for any other meditation. Dance with absolute passion so that the dancer disappears. In the state of absolute passion, when there is tremendous energy, you disappear. Only the act remains. If you are dancing, the dancer will disappear, dancing will remain. And in that state, when the dancer disappears, only dancing remains, meditation is born. Then there is no other need. You need not go anywhere. You need not enter into yoga postures. This is the yoga posture. The dancer has disappeared and dance is there. This is the yoga posture. This is your prayer. In your state of prayer, the actor disappears, the subject disappears, only the verb remains, the praying remains. But as long as the prayer, the one who prays, that remains there, the subject remains there, the ego remains there. Ego vanishes only when the actor disappears, the subject disappears, only the act remains, only praying remains. It is a pure energy, the energy vibrating or overflowing. And in that state you connect. Why in that state do you connect? Remember, when passion is total, ego vanishes. The doer is no more there. And the moment the doer is no more there, ego vanishes of its own accord. Ego exists only in the mediocre minds. And the mediocre minds, it is very difficult for the subject to disappear. Only mediocre people are egoistic. The really great are not egoistic. They cannot be, because their total energy has gone into that act. But their life has a totally different direction, a different dimension. This is the dimension of passion. Have you observed two words, passion and compassion? Passion becomes transformed into compassion when your energy is total, when your intensity is total, when tremendous energy is overflowing in the act that you are doing, your passion becomes compassion, and out of that, something is born out of you, which according to Buddhist terminology is called karuna, the compassion. There is a quantum leap from passion to compassion. A quantum leap from passion to compassion. But quantum leap happens only when you are boiling at 100 degrees. Your inner temperature, your intensity has reached to its pinnacle, the 100 degree mark. Then the water becomes vapors. It is a transformation. It is a quantum leap, water becoming vapors. The water was fluid-like. Vapors move upward. Water which is fluid-like continues to flow from a higher altitude to the lower. Water cannot go from a lower to the higher. The only way the water can go from the lower altitude to the higher, from the street level to your water tank, only when there is put extra force into it. Something extra energy that forces the water from the street level to the level of your water tank. But then from water tank to your water supply, it becomes natural. And this is why we use pump in order water to be pumped up to the height, to send the water to the higher altitude, you have to add extra energy. So in order for your passion to be transformed into compassion, a tremendous energy is required. And it is at that level, when your energy is totally in total, when it is intense, suddenly a quantum leap happens. Your something that was happening at the level of flowing downward, direction changes, it begins to move upward. And here the passion becomes compassion. And compassion is not antagonistic to passion. It is the passion that has blossomed. The spring season of passion has arrived. The fruits are there. The flowers are there. I am in all for passion. Do whatsoever you do, but be lost into it. Dissolve your total being into it. And dissolve. And dissolution becomes salvation. Dissolution becomes salvation. Whatsoever you do, do with totality, with passion, with your intense energy into it.